Digital to well infrastructure and what's happening in the physical world. Ladies and gentlemen, our next speaker will address us on the transformative journey of road infrastructure and the development of that in India and its profound impact on the nation's economy. Under his leadership, India has witnessed unprecedented strides in the expansion and modernization of its road and highway network.
In fact, under his vision and relentless efforts have not only connected remote areas to urban centers, but have also catalyzed some of the economic growth across all sectors. Today, we eagerly anticipate his insights into the symbiotic relationship between robust infrastructure and a thriving economy and the innovative strategies driving India's road to prosperity.
Please join us in welcoming Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, the Honorable Minister of Road Transport and Highways, the government of India. Round of applause as the minister joins us up on stage. I'd also like to request Mr. Vineet Jain, the MD of the Times Group, to join us on stage to welcome the Honorable Minister this evening here at ET Now Global Business Summit. Let's keep that applause going, ladies and gentlemen.
Namaskar, sir.
Well, may we request Shri Vineet Jain to also welcome the Honorable Minister with a shawl, a small token of our gratitude.
Thank you for that, Mr. Jain. And I'd now like to invite up on stage Navika Kumar, Group Editor-in-Chief, Times Now, Nav Bharat and Times Now for an engrossing fireside chat with the Honorable Minister.
Well, Navika, we'll leave it up to you to build it from here onwards.
Thank you very much, Meghna and Sumit, for this opportunity. And thank you, Mr. Nitin Gadkari. I wouldn't be wrong if I introduce you as the rock star mantri of the Modi cabinet. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, rock star, because think Nitin Gadkari and you think of highways as smooth, I wouldn't use Lalu Prasad Yadav's old term, smooth and very, very well made highways. Where you've given me a challenge that we are going to drive on one of those new highways where we'll have a cup of tea and not a drop will fall from the cup. Nitin Gadkari ji, what drives you in this mission to build infrastructure?
Actually, one thing is very clear. If we need capital investment, development in industry, we should have good infrastructure, water, power, transport and communication. Without that, we cannot develop our agriculture, without develop service industry, with the infrastructure, we cannot develop tourism. And there is the most important thing that after 2014, when Modi ji became a prime minister of this country, he has decided to giving highest priority for the development of infrastructure in the country. And previously, when I was minister in Mumbai, I got opportunity to construct Mumbai-Pune Express Highway, Varli-Bandra Sealing Project, 55 flyovers in Mumbai. That reason, when he asked me, I tell him that if you can give me the road transport, by this old experience which I have on the basis of that, I will try to work. And he gave me the opportunity. And today, our network is supposed to be the... Talking to the people that in the end of 2024, our national highway road network will be equivalent to the road network of USA.
And you've already beaten China.
Yes, but I am telling you one incident. One of the USA person coming to me and he meet me, you are wrong. No, sir, what is the thing? So he was telling me, now presently I just get opportunity to go by your road. And it is to be proved to be better than USA, he was telling me. Oh. Now, I'm just telling you the example. From Delhi to Dehradun, 2 hours. Delhi to Jaipur, 2 hours. Delhi to Mumbai, 12 hours. Then Chennai to Bangalore, 2 hours. Bangalore to Mysore now is 1 hour. And we are making 36 express highway. Even from Delhi to Chennai, we are going to reduce the distance by 320 kilometers. And after express highway going to Surat, there will be connectivity to Nasik, Nasik to Ahmednagar, Ahmednagar to Solapur, Solapur to Kurnool, and Kurnool to Trivandrum, Cochin, Kanyakumari, Hyderabad, and Chennai. So this distance is going to reduce by 320 kilometers. And for Chennai, you don't need to go to Mumbai and Pune.
Fantastic. Is there competition between ministers? Because I think you're going to be competition for the railways minister, the civil aviation minister, because everybody will then begin to use your roads.
No, there is no competition. They are doing also their job. I am doing my job. I have a slogan in my office. There are two slogans. One is, I like people who can get the things done. And the second slogan is from American President John F. Kennedy, that American roads are not good because America is rich, but America is rich because American roads are good. When we have decided to make India as a developed country, we are the fastest growing economy in the world, and the dream of the Prime Minister to make Indian economy the third largest economy in the world. For that reason, we need to develop world standard infrastructure in the country, and we are trying our level best to actually up to that mark, we will try to make it.
Mr. Nitin Gadkari, as far as road construction is concerned, you have achieved 90% of targets that have been set, and in 1 year, I think 2021, the COVID era and the COVID was at its peak, and that era was the time when you even surpassed your targets. I want to ask you, how do you manage to do that, given the fact that all this while people have said it's difficult to do the job of building infrastructure because land acquisition takes time, compensations take time, states are involved, there are farmers, there are people who are displaced, and then litigation was a huge part of the problems in building roads. How have you managed to get past all of these roadblocks?
Actually, frankly speaking, still there are problems. I am telling you the example. When I taken charge as a minister, we have 406 projects costing 385,000 crores. And at that time, because of that project, there was an NPA in the Indian banks of 3 lakh crores. It was a very, very big challenge. But we organized the meeting with all stakeholders, with the bankers, with the consultants, with the contractors, concerning officers. We resolved the issue. 40,000 crores of project we terminated. And we saved the Indian bankers from the NPA of 3 lakh crores. But now, one thing which I want to tell you very clearly, what highway we are making, it is not only because of me. This is not my credit. The credit going to my engineers, my contractors, my officers, everyone is working day and night. I am always talking to the people that either it is business, either it is politics, everywhere, the most important thing is the human relationship is the biggest strength of politics and business and everything. So we are working as a team, and I'm just giving them the example that A person works A square, B person works B square, the total work is A square plus B square. But when A and B comes together, thinks together and works together, A plus B bracket square equal to A square plus B square plus twice AB, and that's twice AB is a result of collective team spirit.
Well, I hope you're understanding the politics of the algebra and the manner in which work can be done. Nitin Gadkariji, you're also very passionate about fuel. You're passionate actually about everything you do. You're passionate about road safety. You're passionate about alternative fuels. And every day we see you in Parliament, once in a hydrogen-powered car, once in an electric car. Today we've seen you in a ethanol-powered car. What is your long-term vision as far as alternative fuels are concerned? And how far have we reached? Rasta kitna baki hai?
Actually, the most important thing with the Indian economy is agriculture growth rate is very important. And today we have an import of fossil fuel of 16 lakh crores. I am a farmer. In my area, we have 3 sugar factories. And particularly in my area, 10,000 farmer suicides are there. So our policy is very simple. The diversification of agriculture towards energy, powers, and particularly now, once upon a time, we called Kisan as Annadata. Now it's really a great thing for me. Kisan is not only Annadata, he is Urja Data. He is not only Urja Data, he is Bitumen Data, because we are making bitumen from rice straw, parali. And third is, now Kisan is making Hawaii Indhan Data. The sustainable aviation fuel, we have already started the project in Panipat with Indian Oil, and they are using parali, rice straw, having capacity of 1 lakh liter of ethanol per day, 150 ton of biobitumen per day, and 76,000 ton per year bio aviation fuel. That is sustainable aviation fuel. And in the
Dahod, I think this deserves a bigger round of applause, especially for lungs that are under stress in the city of Delhi. Definitely alternative fuels is something we need to look at.
And actually, now we are making ethanol from sugarcane juice. We are making ethanol from B molasses, C molasses. Now we are making ethanol from corn and rice and all the food grains. Now in Numaligarh in Assam, we have started a factory where they are making ethanol from bamboo. And the new MD who was appointed, previously was in Nagpur, when he was coming to me, I gave him suggestion that you have a pipeline from Numaligarh to Bangladesh for taking petrol and diesel there. You add 20% ethanol of bamboo in that petrol. It will reduce the cost of petrol 2 rupees to Bangladesh, and your whole north is bamboo. It will create job opportunities for the youth of that area. They will cut the bamboo. Bamboo is grass. They cut the bamboo, transport it and give it to you. So now we are making ethanol from biomass, ethanol from bamboo also. The other important thing is, in Punjab and Haryana, majority projects are there. They are making bio-CNG and bio-LNG from rice straw. And now we are, actually the policy is import substitute, cost effective, pollution free and indigenous. I am doing work of 65,000 crores around the Delhi. Delhi is facing the crucial problem of air pollution. Every time when we come to Delhi, there is an infection. So this is the time, the 40% of the pollution is because of my department, transport department. So by after changing this fuel, we will reduce the logistic cost. The most important thing which I want to tell you, that presently in the world scenario, the logistic cost in China is 8 to 10%. Logistic cost in European countries and USA, it is 12%. And India, it is go to 16%. By changing fuel and by making good roads, I am confident that in the end of 24, our logistic cost will be single digit. It comes to 9%, and by which we will increase our export at least 1.5 times. And that is to be most important thing. And by already in G20, biofuel alliance is there. Alternative fuel, lot of things, methanol, ethanol, biodiesel, bio-LNG, and electric, and hydrogen. I have got hydrogen car. The name of the car is Mirai. And that hydrogen car is so beautiful. And actually, I am convincing the people that day by day, if we want to reduce pollution, you should use alternative fuel. Now I am giving you the example of this hotel. Many time I am coming to many program like this, people are asking me, if we use electric and suppose is the problem, the charging is closed, then what do we happen? Now there is no problem like this. I am telling you with the confidence, within 5 years we will have 100% electric buses in the country. Now there is a waiting list in the Indian companies for electric car. And now there are 400 startups started. They are making electric two-wheeler. And now 50% of the two-wheeler we have export. The size of automobile industry when I taken charge as a minister, it was 7.5 lakh crore. At that time our number was 7. And this is the industry which is giving maximum GST to the state government and central government. This is the industry which creates 4 crore 50 lakh jobs. This is the industry which is giving maximum export. And today I am telling you, now after 7 years, our number is 3rd. We just surpassed Japan. Now the first number is China, 2nd is USA, and 3rd is India. And as a transport minister, my mission and my ambition is, within 5 years, India will become a number one automobile manufacturing hub in the world. We have all type of brands are present in the country. And automobile industry will give majority strength to our Indian economy. And we will be Atmanirbhar Bharat. And we will be the 3rd largest economy in the world.
Nitin Gadkari ji, 10 साल का तो शासन हो गया, 2024 तक आपने इतना अचीव कर लिया, आपने 2029 का भी टारगेट सेट कर दिया। वहां प्रधानमंत्री जी कहते हैं अब की बार 400 पार, आपने 29 का टारगेट सेट कर लिया है। चुनाव की जरूरत है या ये सारा पैसा जो खर्चा होगा ये रोड बिल्डिंग में ही लगा दे?
ये मुझे बहुत बार लोग प्रश्न पूछते हैं, तो मैं सरकारी पैसे पर डिपेंड नहीं हूं और मैं ये सब बिजनेसमैन है। मैं आपको एक इंसिडेंट बताता हूं कि अभी मुंबई स्टॉक एक्सचेंज में हमने हमारा बॉन्ड इश्यू इनविट बॉन्ड का लॉन्च किया। 7 दिन का टाइम था और मैं मेरे फैमिली के साथ गोवा में गया। पहले दिन 7 घंटे में 7 आवर्स इन फर्स्ट डे नॉट 7 डेज हमारा बॉन्ड इश्यू 7 टाइम्स ओवर सब्सक्राइब हुआ। और अब मैं आपको बताता हूं, मुझे धनवान लोगों के पैसे से रोड नहीं बनाना है। मैं जो छोटे लोग हैं उनको 8.05% इंटरेस्ट एश्योर्ड पर ईयर उनको दूंगा और मंथली जो रिटायर्ड लोग सभी लोगों के अकाउंट में मंथली इंटरेस्ट जमा करूंगा, तो 8.05 इंटरेस्ट दूंगा। तो मेरा AAA रेटिंग है NHI का, मुझे कोई जरूरत ही नहीं, पैसे की कोई कमी नहीं। मैं आपको एक प्रश्न पूछता हूं, क्या मुझे बताएंगे कि 10 साल में मैंने जो डिक्लेयर किया जो कहा वैसे एक भी बात नहीं हुई? क्या कोई हिंदुस्तान का पत्रकार मुझे बता दे? और अब मैं आपको बताता हूं, ये जो हुआ ये ट्रेलर था, असली फिल्म तो शुरू होना बाकी है। अभी इसके बाद
पिक्चर अभी बाकी है।
अभी 200 रोपवे केबल कार फेनाकुलर रेलवे बना रहा हूं, 10 के अवार्ड अभी कर दूंगा आचार संहिता के पहले। और अब मेरा सपना है ये धोला कुआ से, ये रोड में कितना जाम था आपको पता नहीं, मैं मंत्री बना मुझे दिल्ली मालूम नहीं थी, यही आधा घंटा रहता था, तो मैंने पहले ये रोड बनाया ये झोला कुआ का। अब मैं यहां से पूरे मानेसर तक एक हवा में चलने वाली 40 सीटर की बस चला रहा हूँ, सोच रहा हूं दिल्ली से मुंबई मैं इलेक्ट्रिक बस चला रहा हूं। अभी मैं जेकोस्लाविया स्कोडा के फैक्ट्री में गया था और वहां मैंने 3 बसेस को जोड़कर ट्रॉली बस देखी। और दिल्ली से जयपुर मैं ये बस शुरू करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूं, जिसमें ये बस में एयर कंडीशन होगी, इसमें बिजनेस क्लास होगा, लैपटॉप पर आप देख सकेंगे, 2 घंटे में जयपुर पहुंच जाएंगे और बस का किराया डीजल बस की तुलना में 30% कम होगा और पोल्यूशन 0 होगा।
Well, that is true empowerment. अगर अच्छी सड़क हो, अच्छा सफर हो और सस्ता भी हो, तो शायद देश के आम नागरिक के लिए इससे बेहतर कुछ नहीं हो सकता। एक और एरिया है जो कंसर्न का है, जो है रोड सेफ्टी, जहां एक्सीडेंट्स रोड पर जो होते हैं, हमारे जो हाईवेज होते हैं, our highways sometimes even have speed breakers, we have animals coming on them, we have all kinds of transport on it, and risk of accidents and accident numbers are high. How do we plan to address this issue?
Actually, frankly, main accept karta hu ki 10 saal mein ye ek hi subject hai jisme mujhe safalta nahi mili. 1,68,000 1,68,000 mautein hoti hai, 5 lakh accident hote hain और मरने वालों की संख्या जो है 18 to 35, इस ग्रुप के 60% लोग मरते हैं, और इसका कारण है एक रोड इंजीनियरिंग एटोवेल इंजीनियरिंग, दोनों में हमने सुधार किया। तीसरा एजुकेशन और इन्फोर्समेंट और इमरजेंसी, इसमें भी काम हुआ। हम लोग सभी की मदद करते हैं, आदरणीय स्वामी जी भी बैठे, इनको भी हमने अभी कल में अमिताभ बच्चन जी के साथ, सुधा मूर्ति के साथ हमने कार्यक्रम किए, स्वामी जी ने को भी पिछले साल अमिताभ बच्चन और वो, और हम सब उसको प्रचार करते हैं। पर एक बात जरूर है कि हमारे हिंदुस्तानी लोगों का माइंड सेटअप, ह्यूमन बिहेवियर जब तक नहीं बदलेगा कि रेड सिग्नल है तो रुकना चाहिए, अगर स्कूटर चलाना है तो हेलमेट लगाना चाहिए, मोबाइल फोन कान पर लगाकर गाड़ी ड्राइव नहीं करनी चाहिए, स्कूटर नहीं चलानी चाहिए, ये छोटी छोटी बातों के बारे में हम लोगों को समझाने का प्रयास करते। मेरा एक्सीडेंट हुआ है, मैं जब महाराष्ट्र में लीडर ऑपोजिशन था तो 4 जगह मेरा पैर टूटा हुआ है, 2 साल मेरे गए, और जिन घर से कोई मृत्यु होती है वो कितना भयंकर उसके ऊपर संकट आता है मैंने देखा है। पर अनफॉर्चुनेटली हम बहुत कोशिश कर रहे हैं, अभी रोड इंजीनियरिंग में हमने ब्लैक स्पॉट 8,000 निकाले, 4,500 दुरुस्त कर दिए, अभी ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग में हमने स्टार रेटिंग लाया, इसके कारण हमारे स्टार रेटिंग के कारण 6 एयरबैग भी लग रही है सब जगह, उसमें जितना होने लायक है वो भी हमने किया। इन्फोर्समेंट में हमने नया मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट भी लाया, फाइन भी बढ़ा दिया, पर अब हमारी आवश्यकता यह है कि हम कैसा भी करके ह्यूमन बिहेवियर को बदले, जिसमें मीडिया का, एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशन का, सोशल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का सहयोग से हम लोगों का माइंड सेटअप, उनका जो ह्यूमन बिहेवियर है वो बदलने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। कानून भी कड़ा किया है, कैमरे भी लगे हैं, पर लोगों में सुधार नहीं होता, ये एक प्रॉब्लम है, पर सबके सहयोग से अब इसको सुधारने की कोशिश करेंगे।
वेल एज अ मीडिया ग्रुप वी आर विद यू इन क्रिएटिंग अवेयरनेस एंड ब्रिंगिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ रोड सेफ्टी एजुकेशन। एज अ मीडिया ग्रुप आई कैन से दैट वी विल ऑल बी कमिटेड टू दिस। ये सब तो हो गई इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर की, आपके पैशन की बात। अब कुछ ही हफ्ते रह गए हैं, चुनाव का अनाउंसमेंट होने वाला है, रिजल्ट पहले से पता है?
देखिए, मैं भी लोकसभा लड़ा हूं 2 बार, और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हम लोग जब अच्छा कार्य करते हैं तो कास्ट, क्रीड, सेक्स, रिलीजन, लैंग्वेज, इसके ऊपर उठकर लोग मतदान करते हैं। पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ प्रोग्रेस एंड डेवलपमेंट, ये हमारे राजनीति का भाग है। और आपको सही बता दूं, मैं तो 90% पॉलिटिशियन हुई नहीं, मैं मैक्सिमम सेवा का काम करते रहता हूं, हमारे क्षेत्र में काम कर रहता हूं। और मेरा विश्वास, और इस बार मैंने कहा भी है कि मैं ना पोस्टर लगाऊंगा ना बैनर लगाऊंगा, मैं आपका आशीर्वाद लेने के लिए आपके पास जरूर आऊंगा। और मेरा विश्वास है कि जो अच्छा काम होता है, पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट का काम होता है, गरीबों के लिए काम होता है, वो जात पंथ धर्म भाषा की दीवारों को तोड़ देता है। मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में 10 साल में इस देश की प्रगति और विकास जो हुआ है, जो आप सबके सामने है, हमारा देश कहां था और कहां है, तो मुझे लगता है कि मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में फिर से एक बार हमें बहुत अच्छा समर्थन मिलेगा, मेजोरिटी मिलेगी, और हमारा सरकार निश्चित रूप से चुनकर आएगा।
एंड नितिन गडकरी, व्हाट इज योर पर्सनल विजन फॉर योरसेल्फ इन द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर्स?
वो तो प्रधानमंत्री जी के ऊपर है कि वो मुझे कौन सा डिपार्टमेंट देंगे, वो काम मैं करूंगा।
ऑन दैट नोट, वेल लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, प्रेजेंटिंग टू यू मिस्टर नितिन गडकरी।
थैंक यू, बहुत बहुत।
वेल, there is a standing ovation coming in for the work you have done, Mr. Nitin Gadkari, and you know, that speaks volumes for the work that has been done. Thank you very much for joining us here.
Thank you, Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, and thank you, Navika, for a very engrossing and interesting conversation.
And thank you so much for the standing ovation. However, a quick